Rosie Annette here with Brushes, Biceps, and Fights, and today I'm gonna do a What's in My Gym Bag video. I've been thinking about doing this video for a while. It just hasn't happened. In case you guys don't know, a lot of you know that I probably used to work out with DVDs at home if you followed me for a while, but recently I've gotten into the gym life and have been going to the gym a lot. Just switching it up, trying something new, kind of hit a plateau with DVDs. I love them. I do think they're effective, but I needed to switch it up. I joined 3S Fitness, which is Abby Espen's Shades company. So I've been following her program, and I've been loving it. So before we get into what's in my gym bag, I just thought I'd tell you that everything on my face, pretty much, is from the Cinderella collection. Highlight, blush, eyeshadow, lipstick, lip gloss. I will link that video down below as well that I did of my Cinderella haul so you guys can really see what it's all about if you're interested. Now time to get into what's into my gym bag. This is just a Nike gym bag. I believe it's a size medium. I was using this for school when I went to the National Personal Training Institute. And now it's become my gym bag, and the first thing I'm going to just go in order as I see things in this bag is my towel. This is just a towel my dad bought me. There's blue fuzz all over it from Lululemon. It's just a pink towel that I use. I don't sweat a lot typically, but I still like to have a towel just to wipe down the machines for when other people have been on them. And my gym does give hand out free towels if you need them when you're working out, but they're a little rough, so I just prefer to bring my own. It's softer on my face if I wipe my face off and all that kind of jazz, so there is that. Then I have this bag. I am so cheap by using a plastic bag. This is just an extra change of clothes because I keep my gym bag in my car so that if I'm ever out somewhere and I decide, hey, I want to hit up the gym, I have everything with me and I don't have to come back home. So I have a pair of socks from Lululemon. These are my favorite socks to work out in. They have like the little, like, I call it a duck tail. And there are specific feet, like you can see how it's tapered. So you don't get that annoying, like, knobby thing in the side of your sock that when your foot's in your shoe is really obnoxious to me. Then I have my 3S Fitness Muscle and Mascara Tee. And then I just have a plain black pair of shorts from Lululemon. And a plain black sports bra from Lululemon, and my headband from Lululemon. One thing you guys will notice is I have a lot of headbands in here because, oh my god, my bangs when I work out drive me insane. So the next thing I have in here is my, like, after workout bag. Again, another plastic bag. Big fan of these. It's a really cheap way to carry your stuff to and from the gym, and if it gets sweaty and stinky and whatever, oh well, just grab another one. And here I have a hairbrush. This is like a dollar at my local supermarket. They are my favorite. I have some dry shampoo. I don't use this a lot because typically I go to the gym and I come straight home and shower. And I'm a bad girl and I wash my hair every day, so I don't go through dry shampoo a lot. But you never know when you will need it, and better safe than sorry. Then I have just some pink. This is the Hot Crush Body Mist because you gotta smell good afterwards. I just have a deodorant. This is the Right Guard Fresh Scent Invisible Solid. And another headband. This one is from the brand Goody. And an extra hair tie because, God forbid, a hair tie break and it'll, ugh, worst thing ever to happen at the gym. Okay. Next thing in here is my running belt, which I don't use at the gym. I just thought I would include this in this video just so you guys know that when I go, because I am training for a half marathon, when I go running outside, I fill one of these up with water and one up with amino acids just to keep my levels up, protect my muscles. So I always have water with me on my run because you need to stay hydrated. It also has a little pocket. And here is where I normally put my keys, as well as my chapstick, because chapped lips are no fun. So I just thought I'd include that, and let me see. This is by Nathan, in case you guys are curious. Next, I have, now you guys are going to think I'm crazy, I have two pairs of shoes in my gym bag. I have this pair of Nikes and this pair of Asics. These are my running shoes. They are a half a size bigger than any of my lifting shoes because your feet swell when you run. So if I have to run on the treadmill, you know, if it rains here, which is very rare, but it has happened, I have them with me and I can get her done. And these are the Asics IGSs, I think. I don't know. I'm really bad with remembering what shoes I buy. And these are my Nikes. These are the Structure 17s. I have custom inserts in these. So they're very supportive. They're a stability shoe. So for lifting, I have all the support I need. So, yeah, there are the shoes that I take to the gym. Now, I have two sets of headphones that I bring to the gym. And I actually had to buy a new pair because these ones, one of the headphones just quit working on my last run. But these are just little Skull Candy earbuds. I prefer these for long distance runs only. That's the only time I ever wear these. Every other time I wear my wireless Beats Solo 2s. They connect through Bluetooth through my phone, so I don't have a wire, which is a big deal for me because I am very little. So those armbands that you put your phone in, none of them fit me. They all just slide right down my arm. So I either have to put my phone in my sports bra or tuck it somewhere else if it's wired. And these, I don't like them for long runs because they don't hurt when I'm lifting for like an hour and a half. But if I run with them from like the bouncing, they'll start to hurt back here. But I love them. They are rather pricey, but they were definitely a great investment. I have another pair of socks in my gym bag because I really hate when a sock won't stay up. These Lululemon ones, these are the same ones, just a different color. The ones with the little heel. Every once in a while a sock won't stay up or something will just be funky and I'll fixate on it and it'll drive me nuts. So I have an extra pair of socks. Then I have my heart rate monitor. Where's the third piece? Here it is. It's a Polar. This is my Polar FT4. I also have a Polar FT7. This is the little clip that clips on to your chest strap. It's bad to leave these connected all the time. It will drain your battery life of it. So always disconnected. I use this to track my heart rate during my runs, my calories during my lifts. It's just one of my favorite fitness devices that I have and probably my favorite thing in this bag. Just because I am kind of OCD and I really like to know all my numbers and all my stats that I possibly can. Then I have my lifting gloves. I got these at like Sports Authority or someplace like that. Maybe it was Dick's Sporting Goods. These are by Bionic. I think they are an extra small. They just protect my hands from getting calloused, help me grip the weights a little better. If you guys are planning on starting weightlifting, ladies, these are a great investment. Then the last and final thing I have, and this wasn't technically in my gym bag because I just washed it, is my blender bottle. This one only holds, I think it's 16 ounces, somewhere in there. And I had two little stacker things on it. And when I go to the gym, I put 8 ounces of water in this with one scoop of NLA for her uplift. This is the cherry lime flavor. This is the only flavor of this I've tried and I love it. And I'll drink 4 ounces before I start my workout. Then when I get ready to start my workout, I will fill it up to the 12 ounce marks, add 8 ounces more of water. And I will add a scoop of NLA for her aminos just to help my muscles recover faster. And it just says, they do, here, it says increases energy endurance, helps build lean muscles, and enhances recovery. This is in the flavor pink lemonade. And just to throw this out there, I am not sponsored in any way or affiliated with NLA for her. I just really like their products. Then after my workout, I always have two scoops of my NLA for her. This is the chocolate eclair whey protein powder. I prefer the vanilla cupcake one. I'm more of a vanilla person, but if you're more of a chocolate person, this will be great. I just ordered this one this time. Just to switch it up, try something different. Then I have these. I don't take to the gym, but I just thought I would include them in this video. Every morning at breakfast, I take one NLA for her Shred Her Thermogenic Fat Burner and one NLA for her Omega. I only take one of these a day. They do say to take two, but I have a very low caffeine tolerance, so I don't want to like overdo it too often. Then the last and final thing that I keep in my gym bag is a Quest bar. Right now I have the Quest S'mores protein bars. These are not my favorite flavor. I really prefer the cookies and cream one, if I can get that out, to this, but it is still great post-workout. Sometimes I'll eat half before, half after, just depending on when the last time I have eaten was. And that is all, let me double check. Yep, that is all that is in my gym bag. So I hope you guys liked this video. I will link everything I can find online down below for you guys. And if you guys have any questions, please always feel free to comment. And if you guys want more types of videos like this, let me know down below. And I hope you guys have an awesome day, night, evening, wherever you are in the world watching this video. And I will see you guys next time. Bye.